मकरतुंड महाकाय सूर्यकोटि संप्रभो निर्विघ्नं कुरु मे देव सर्वकार्येषु सर्वदा सरस्वति नमस्तुभ्यं वरदे कामरूपिणी विद्यारम्भं करिष्यामि सिद्धिर्भवतु मे सदा वागर्थाव्यो संप्रप्तो वागर्थ प्रतिपत्ते जगतः पितरो वंदे पार्वती परमेश्वरो येनाक्षरसमाम्नायमधिगम्य महेश्वरात् कृष्णं व्याकरणं प्रोक्तं तस्मै पाणिनये नमः। वाक्यकारं वररुचिं भाष्यकारं पतञ्जलिं पाणिनिं सूत्रकारं च प्रणतोऽस्मि मुनित्रयम्। धातुर्ब्रह्मैव सम्प्रोक्तो जीव आख्यातमुच्यते प्रकृतिकृसुबन्धादिर्धातुब्रह्मात्मने नमः। शुक्लां ब्रह्मविचारसारपरमां माध्यां जगद्व्यापिनीं वीणापुस्तकधारिणीम् अभेदां चाड्यान्द्रपारापहां हस्ते स्फाटिकमालिकां द्विदधतीं पद्मासने संस्थितां वन्देतां परमेश्वरीं भगवतीं बुद्धिप्रदां शारदाम् तत्त्वा सरस्वतीं देवीं शुद्धां गुह्यां करोम्यहं पाणिनीय प्रवेशाय लघुसिद्धान्तकौमुदी। कंटिन्यूइंग विथ अवर हलंत पुल्लिंग शब्द वी हैव पकारांत गुप गुप शब्द। सो गुपा गोपने धातु टेक्स अ क्विप प्रत्यय इन कर्तरी मीनिंग। सो गुप गोपने मीन्स टू कंसील in the meaning of concealing, the gup dhatu takes quip pratyaya and you will have a concealer gup plus quip where apruktasya. So pakarasya ropa by halantyam ittasya ropa then kakara by lashakvatadite. So you have v left and this is actually upadeshi jannasika it, it's an anunasika kikara which will also go away, but for the purposes of the sutra we will decline as vehe in shashti ekvachana. So vehe apruktasya, अपृक्त इज एकाल प्रत्यय, सो सिंगल लेटर प्रत्यय इज कॉल्ड एज अपृक्त एंड इफ इट इज वकारा देन वे हे अपृक्तस्य लोपः दैट विल आल्सो गो अवे, सो इट्स अ जीरो प्रत्यय, यू गेट गुप। सो गुप मीन्स द कंसीलर, गुप धातु नाउ हैज बिकम गुप द पद सॉरी प्रातिपदिक विच इज कंसीलर, बट विथ क्विप प्रत्यय I think there is a paribhasha which says that the kvibantaha dhatuttvam na jahati. The kvibanta will not give up the dhatu samgya. Even if it is at the end of the pada, pratipadika or a pada, still the dhatu should be visible. It is seen. It is still seen as a word ending with a dhatu. This will be useful later. So just a note there. So how does it decline? Lagukara says gup or gub. So gup or gub. Pakara by kharicha. Vavasane char. Not kharicha. Vavasane char. And this is jastvam. Jastvam will give vargatritya. So pakara will become pa-pa-ba bakara. Then just varna milana. Gup plus au gupau. Gup plus as. Prutta visarga. Gupaha. Gubhyam. This is because of pada. There is jastvam. So jhalam jashwanti will be applied here and here jash, and this is basically char letter varga prathama, it will come back vavasani. So there is optional form gup and gup. So gup plus su halnyabhyo dirga sutisya priktam hal lopaha, so su will go away because it is hal after a halanta gup and it is hal. So this hal stands for the pakara here and this hal stands for the su here, sakara which remains after that hal and it is su hal. The hal belong to su will go away after a halanta dhatu. So we'll have gup and jhalam jashanti will give you varga tritiya jash, so it will become gub and then vavasane char, so we'll get bakara can optionally become pakara, so you'll get gub or gup in prathama ekvachana. So gub or gup, गुपौ गुपः गुपं गुपौ गुपः गुपा गुभ्यां गुभ्भि इत्यादि इन दि भकारस्थान. वेन वेन एवर देर इज अ अजादि प्रत्यय देन इट विल गेट लूज ए पद संज्ञा, इट विल बिकम भ एंड इन भ स्थान यू विल हैव जस्ट वर्ण मिलन और सम संधि, बट हियर देर इज नो संधि बिटवीन अ हल एंडिंग गुप एंड अजादि प्रत्यय, देयरफॉर देयर वर्ण मिलन. And of course, sandhi meaning, I meant this gupas will become gupaha by rutva visarga, that is the sandhi. And gupo also. In the last supsthana, gup plus sup pakara will go away by halanti mit and then just varna milana gupsu. Then the next halanta pullinga shabda taken is tadrush. How do you get tadrush? So tadrush means similar to that, that which is similar to that. In that sense tadrush shabda is used. So there is a vidhi sutra for derivation of tadrush. So tyadadishu drushona lo tyadadishu drushona lochane kanch queen. So queen as well as kanch. So here kanch cha is there. So kanch or queen pratyaya are used. Chakarat queen also and kanch has been mentioned. So both of these pratyas are ordained after what? After drush dhatu. Drushaha. Drusha would be panchami then. After drush dhatu, kanch or kany or queen pratyaya are ordained. When this drush dhatu is not in the meaning of this vishaya saptami, it is not in the sense of alochana. Alochana is in the sense of knowing. So when it is not, drush dhatu is not in the sense of knowing, analochane, then after this drush, kanch or queen pratyaya are added, and this will bring about a samasa upapada tatpurusha. So it needs an upapada. Tatra upapadam saptamistham. So tatra in the dhatu adhikara, tatra dhatu adhikari, which starts from 3191. In that adhikara, tatra upapadam saptamistham. Whatever is in the saptami or upapada, that is upapada, or you can say upapada will be placed in saptami. Saptamyam tishtati iti saptamistham. So that is a saptamas, it will be in saptami. So whatever is in the seventh case, that is considered as an upapada. So upapada to the dhatu, upasamipe, samipe uccharitam padam will be upapada. Therefore, this tyadadi is in saptami and it is upapada, saptami. Tyadadi in the tyadadi gana starting with tyad. In the sarvadi gana there is tyadadi. Tyadadi is a subset of sarvadi gana. So in sarvadi gana starting with tyad, namely tyad, tad, yad, etad, idam and others. Eka, dvi, yushmad, asmad, bhavatu, kim. These are all meant by tyadadishu. So when any of these are there in close proximity, pronounced in close proximity, upapada, to drishdhatu which is not in the meaning of alochana, then that dhatu with the tyadadi pada will be taking will become a samasa by taking kanj pratyaya. So you'll see what happens is that tyadadishu upapadeshu analochan arthad drushehe kanj syat chat quin. So what happens is that in the prakriya avastha itself drush will take this quin pratyaya or kanj pratyaya and then it will get mixed up with the tyadadi gana. So here tad is taken as an example here because our word is tadrusha. So tad is taken, tad plus drish plus queen. So this is the upapada. And tyadadishu upapade drish, which is not in the meaning of alochana. So this is in meaning of analochana. Analochane is a, it has taken queen pratyaya. Queen pratyaya content is also zero. It's a by way apruktasya quip queen. All these will lose the entire content, so it is zero pratyaya. So tad plus drush, it will become tadrush. So we have derived tadrush. Now this, so look at this note. Queen pratyaya ending word declines in all genders and there is no stri pratyaya to be attached, meaning it will be tadrush only in strilinga also. See, when drush is in the sense of knowing, meaning alochana meaning, then an karmanyan, this sutra applies. So it will not take queen or kanj pratyaya. So example is given tatpashyatiti tadrushaha. So tat here is in second case singular, upapada, karmani and. So it is a karma. And karmani meaning what? Karmani here, karmani is seventh case singular. And is in first case singular. And is a pratyaya ordained. After what? After the drushdhatu, but karmani upapade. This seventh case is upapada tatpurusha. Sorry, not upapada, upapada. It is an upapada. So this upapade saptami, this is upapade saptami, So karmani, when there is a karma, tat in which is upapada, it is in pronouns in proximity to the drushdhatu, and drushdhatu form will be what? Pashyati. So tat pashyati, one sees that iti tadrushaha. So this tadrusha is in the meaning of alochana. There drush is in the meaning of alochana, so in the meaning of knowing or seeing. So tat pashyati iti tadrusha. But if you look at this tadrusha, you'll see this will, it will decline as tadruk. So tadruk will be something similar. It has absolutely no meaning. Drush is not carrying the meaning of seeing or knowing. So that is explained in the tippana here. So now we have got this tad plus drush, tadrush. What happens later? For that we need more sutra. And thereby Laghukara reads Vidhi Sutra Asarvanamnaha. Asarvanamnaha. So Asarvanamnaha kim? Druk drushav vatushu. So this drushdhatu, drush, it should be drusha, not drush here, drusha. So this is drush, drusha or vatu. So when any of these three are there, drush, drusha or vatu, vatushu, what will happen? Asarvanamna. So, and this is what? This is parasaptami. Parasaptami. When drush, drusha or vatu kind of words follow a sarvanama, sarvanamnaha, sarvanamnaha, then sarvanama will take what? Aadesha. Where will the Aadesha go? It is an antyadesha. So the sarvanama followed by drush, drusha or vatu is will take Aadesha. So last letter, antyadesha by alontyasya. Alontyasya will apply and there will be Aadesha. So here if you look at it, the last letter is replaced by Alontyasya. So here Tad is the last, Tad is the Upapada where Dakara and Tad is what? It is a Sarvanama. So this is a Sarvanama. So since it is a Sarvanama pronoun, Tad plus Drush. So Drush, Drusha or Vatu. So we have Drush, this condition is met. Druk. So Druk, this condition is met. So drug drusha vatushu. So there what happens is that now dakara will be replaced by akara. So tadrush here, tadrush will become what? Tadrush. Dakara will be replaced by akara because it's the last letter, and here we'll use alontyasya. Alontyasya paribhasha, whereby we'll have antyadesha, antyadesha, dakara will become akara. So tadrush. Now we have tadrush. What will happen? This is ta and so ta, dakara is replaced. So ta, akara and akara together will be become akara by akasavarani dirga. There is a savarna sandhi, savarna dirga sandhi. So now we have tadrush. And what will this be? This tadrush is what? It is a krut. It is krudanta. So therefore krudanta, because it has taken quin pratya, quin is a krut pratya, therefore you will get krut taddita samasascha pratipadikam sutra, whereby krudanta tadrush is called as pratipadika. Now you can decline it. Tadrush plus sun. What happens? Hal niyabhyo dirgat sutisya pruktam hal lopaha. Tadrush is hal ending, and therefore this suhal is going to be lupta. It will lupyate, it will go away. Lopaha. So lopasyat. Or lupyate. Actually here hal lopa means hal lupyate. Su sakara goes away. Now this sutra we have seen earlier. Vrashcha vrashcha srujam rujayaja raja bhraj chasham shaha. So the shakara, murdhanya shakara is the adesha for currently our nimitta is shakara ending. Shankar shakara ending. Words will take, padas will take what? Jhali padasya antecha. So when followed by jhal or at padanta. So our condition is padanta here. It is not followed by jhal letter. It is followed by nothing. So padasya anta. So it is a pada. Suptingantam padam. Therefore tadrush. This shakara will become tadrush. Will become shadmukh shakara. Murdhanya. Now jhalam jashu ante will cause shakara to become dakara by Stani antartama also. Stani antartamaha. Tartamaha. So thereby stani antartamattam shakara will become dakara. Because jas is what javagada dash and shakara is murdhanya. And in javagada dash only dakara is murdhanya. So murdhanyatvat stani antartamattam between shakara and dakara, thereby tadrish will become tadrid. Then quin pratyasya ku, that which can take quin pratya, or in this case it has taken quin pratya, that will take kutvam. Kavarga adesha padasyante, when it is at the end of the pada, thereby dakara will become what? Kavarga. Dakara is tavarga, so tavarga tritiya it is jash. So tavarga tatha will become varga tritiya of kavarga kakhaga. So therefore varga tritiya, this is third, this is also third jash varga tritiya, therefore we will get tadruk. Now tadruk vavasane char, so this is one form, and tadruk vavasane char gakara can optionally become char, which is first of the class char. Thereby tadruk or tadruk, this is the declension for the first case singular. Then tadrush plus au will be varnamilna tadrushav tadrusha tadrukbhyam. So you see laghu vritti said what? Tadruk tadruk here, and then tadrushav tadrusha tadrukbhyam. Did we do the vritti here? Yeah. So here sarvanamna akaraha antadesha syat drugdrush vatushu. So when drugdrush or vatu follow, then antadesha, last letter is replaced by akara of a sarvanama. And therefore you get tadruk or tadruk in first case singular. In dual you get tadrushav, this is prathama ekvachana, prathama dvivachana as well as dvitiya dvivachana. Tadrushah in prathama bahuvachana as well as dvitiya bahuvachana, tadrushah, all of these. Then in padasthana tadrukbhyam, because there will be jashtvam by jhalam jashuante, it will get padasanya, and therefore jhalam jashuante will apply. There is no possibility of vavasana or kharicha, therefore there is no chartvam, because there is no khar letter following and there is no avasana also. So tadrukbhyam is the only form. Tadrukbhyam, tadrukbhi ityadi, tadrukbhya. So here you look at vrashcha vrashcha, this sutra will apply through and through. Shakara will become shanmukh shakara, then jashtvam dakara, then quin patyasya ku gakara, and it will stop here. Tadrukbhyam, tadrukbhi, tadrukbhyam, then everywhere else varna melana and rutto visarga as needed. Tadrusho tadrusha ityadi tadrusham, and except the last tadruksho, what will happen? Tadruk kharicha, sakara is following, therefore kharicha char chartom will apply, gakara will become kakara, and then varna melana will give tadrukshu. But before that, inkoho adesha pratyayo, inkoho will also cause this su pratyaya will become shu, because the pratyaya sakara which is preceded by ku, inkoho ku, therefore the apadanta sakara will take murdhanya adesha, and then varna melana with kakara will give you tadrukshu. Similarly about yadrush, meaning similar to whichever, etadrush like this, twadrush is like you, madrush is like me, and asmadrush is like us, yushmadrush is like all of you, and yushmadrush is like you, and bhavadrush is like the respected sir or madam, whatever, you know, preferably in third person, not you directly, not you, otherwise it will become twadrush. Ski drush is like what, and then e drush is like this, similar to etadrush idam. So here etat, here idam, so all these are with the tyadadi gana. And you can see that none of these is carrying the meaning of drishdhatu in alochana, in seeing meaning or in knowing meaning. None of these are in that meaning. Therefore, we see the sutra analochane has the word analochane, and thereby that sutra has pravritti here. When kanj suffix, kan pratyaya is ordained kanj or quin. So quin we have seen. What happens if you add kanj pratyaya? So if you add kanj pratyaya, kakara will go by lashakvata dite, nyakara will go by halantyam tasse lopaha, akara is the content. So akara remains, only akara remains. So tyadarishu drushu analochane kanch. Here we have taken kanch pratyaya. Queen we have already done. So with kanch, a is the content. So everything else will be same. Pratyaya is different. That's all. So instead of queen, you will have the everything else in the sense derivation of the pratipadika. Everything is the same. So asarvanamnah will apply. Akasavarna dirgha will apply, and you will get tad. Instead of tadrush, you will get tadrusha. So with tadrusha in the same meaning as tadrush, it will become akara endings. And if it is akara ending, it will decline like what we have already seen. So Rama Shabda. So tadrusha, tadrusho, tadrusha ityadi. It will Rama Shabda, sorry, Sarva Shabda, because it is a pronoun. And since it is akara ending, now in feminine it will take ni and it will become tadrushi and then decline like nadi. So the only difference is that it will become akara ending, and once it becomes akara ending, this only difference will make a huge difference in declension. In the derivation of the pratipadika, there is not much of a change. Other sutras are same. It is only that you will have an akara ending shabda. So this is not a part of laghu, because laghu will not go across the because you don't see any laghu vritti like that. Laghu will not go across the shabdas. If he has taken up hal ending shabda, he'll stick to hal ending. He'll not even talk about, laghukara will not talk about any other area that the sutra touches. Only whatever is his example, in that example, whatever is the part of the sutra that is useful, he'll talk only about that. Everything else is homework. So further here, wish. So wish is to enter.
Praveen.
Sorry, did you have a question?
Yeah. But for a queen and kant, is the meaning the same?
Yes, meaning is same. Because see, okay, it is in the, what does it say? See, meaning will depend on, if you look at this, tyadarishu drusho analochane kancha. There is no meaning mentioned here. There is absolutely no meaning. So what is the meaning? Upapada. Whenever there is an upapada, it will just mix up with that. So now if you look at it, the most of this, see, this is in 3 to 60 section. So in 3 to 60 section, this is in the dhatu adhikara. So in the dhatu adhikara, everything that is in the seventh case is in upapada. Only in that adhikara. So upapada will go with the dhatu. So whatever is the dhatu artha, what is the meaning of the upapada? So that sambandha, whatever you read in the, in a non-samastha, the same meaning will be carried. So there is no particular meaning mentioned. This meaning you have to understand with, if there, I'm not talking about on this sutra, but in this section, the meaning will be, is not, unless given, there is no particular meaning which is applying. So whatever meaning applies with a asamastha pada, with a vyastha pada, the same meaning will apply. So it will all depend on the vigraha vakya. So here you see there is no vigraha vakya specifically given. So what will happen is non-alochana meaning. So what is the other meaning? So if you look at it, the meaning is like a nipata. What is the meaning given? It is a rudi artha. Tadrusha means similar to that. Because otherwise drushdhatu has no such meaning. Where is the meaning of similarity in drushdhatu? It is not there. So these are all very particular rudi artha meanings which you get. How you derive is known here, but the meaning is not mentioned. Okay. But kanch, cha and quin. So cha has been mentioned. Therefore, whatever is the meaning with quin pratyaya, the same meaning will apply to kanch also. There is no specific mention at all.
Okay.
So now vish. So vishdhatu. Vishdhatu is in the meaning of entering, to enter. So when it takes a quip pratyaya, it will become karta. So you will get the same dhatu kind of a form, vish itself, but it means one who enters. So visha, praveshane, vish plus quip will give you, it's a zero pratyaya. So everything will go away, vera pruktasya. Then this quip cha by dhato pratyaya parasya, quip cha is a sutra which ordains quip. After the dhato pratyaya parasya, after the dhato pratyaya will, so paraha tells after what dhato, after a dhatu pratyaya, which pratyaya, quip pratyaya. So quip cha will come in, and this is kartari. Usually you will get karta. So kartari, kartari krit, but you will kartari krit. Sutra is kartari krit. Whichever sutra in this, in the krit adhikara, wherever you see krit, there unless the meaning is mentioned. If the meaning is mentioned, like for karmani, etc., or in adhikarane, meaning lut will come in, or there is a large adhikara which says that akartari cha kareke sanyayam. So there, in non-karta meaning, lut pratyaya may come in. So such adhikaras or particular sutras are there which mention the meaning. If it is not mentioned, then all krit pratyas where there is no adhikara prapta artha or sutra prapta artha, then the artha is kartari, kartari krita. General utsarga rule is whenever no specific meaning is mentioned for the pratyaya, it will all be in the kartari meaning. So here you look at wish plus quip is in karta meaning, scripture, which meaning kartari krita. So therefore wish is a karta, karta of what? Whatever is a dhatu artha, to enter, meaning the one who enters, that is the meaning, one who enters is wish. And because it is a kridanta shabda pratipadika, so these are all very easy, we have seen many times. Lagukara says vrashcha ityadi, vrashcha iti sha. So vrashcha means vrashcha, vrashcha ityadi sutra. It is shakara ending dhatu, therefore this shakara will become nimitta to become shanmukh shakara, and thereby what will happen? Vrashcha iti shaha, shaha desha. So this is the step he is talking about. Vish will become visha, shakara vish. Then jastve chartve. So jastva will also take place, chartva also. This is neuter. Prathama dvivachana. So he said jastva also and chartva also. So what will you get? So jastva will give you dakara, which we saw earlier with the different word but same similar sutra. Shakara became shakara, shakara became dakara by jastva, and sthaniyantartama, then chartva will give you takara. So these are the two forms. One is vid, second is vit. So it means one who enters, vid or vit. So you'll get vit, vid, as per Lagukara also two forms are given. Then varna melana vish plus au, vishau, vishaha, vidibhyam. So this is padasthana. In all the padasthana you'll get vidibhyam, vidibhihi, vidibhyaha, those forms. And in sustana what you'll get? Supstana, the saptami bahuvachana. Vid plus su, you'll get vitsu. Vitsu, or I think dhudagama may come in, you'll get vitsu. So see, vitsu, here vitsu, by this su following is a khar letter, therefore khari cha char. So this is a charadesha. There's a charadesha, and here you'll get what? Dhudagama. So if you take dhudagama is optional, therefore you'll get dhudagama, and then it become vitsu. We have seen all this earlier. Nash, next word is nash. Dhatu is also nash, nasha adarshane, nasha adarshane. So what happens? Dhatva dehe shoshaha is the sutra. Shosa, shakara, shanmukh shakara at the beginning of the dhatu will become sakara when you take it out. So what happens is that before this 6164 is dhatva dehe shosha, shosa. So sho will, shakara will become sakara. Example, there is shta, gati nivruttau. Shta, when it comes out of dhatu patha, it will become stha. And nimitta paaye, naimitte kasya apya paaya, therefore shtha in the dhatu patha becomes shtha, and once it becomes shtha, this thakara is of thakara. Thakara had become thakara when sakara became shakara. So when shakara goes back to sakara, then thakara will also go back to thakara. So that's how you get stha dhatu, gati nivrutto. So next sutra is nona. It says that the nakara at the beginning of the dhatu, dhatvade nakarasya, naha adesha hoti, nakara adesha hoti. Therefore nakara will become nakara as soon as you take out the dhatu nash from the nasha adarshane from dhatu patha. So it will become nash. Then you add quip to it. Once you add quip, quip is a zero pratyaya. Now suptingantam padam. Therefore nash is adarshane, one which so nasha rudi artha is gets destructed. So one who perishes or destructs is, gets destructed. So destructs, or we can say adarshana, meaning literally dhatu padam is adarshana, one who ceases to be. Before, one who was there or one that was there ceases to be or unmanifest. In Vedanta the meaning taken is unmanifest. From manifest to unmanifest is called as nasha. So that is a Vedanta meaning. Here we'll take, we can take cease to be, destructs, whatever meaning in loka. So nash is a pada now. Veya pruktasya, we'll take away क्विप वकार ऑल्सो नश नश इज अ पद एंड इट इज वॉट नॉट अ पद सॉरी इट इज अ प्रातिपदिका बाय कृत्तद्वित समासाश्च नाउ नश व्हेन यू डिक्लाइन एंड विधि सूत्र इज नीडेड सो नशेर्वा नशेर्वा नशे सो नश धातु नशे हे धातु हो वा सो यर नश इज अ धातु हाउ डू वी नो नश इज अ धातु दी नशे हे इज सिक्स की सिंगुलर ऑफ नशी एंड वॉट इज नशी इक्ष्टिपौ धातु निर्देशे सो इक इट इज एन इक स्टिप इक और स्टिप आर यूज सॉरी इक्स इक्ष्टिपौ धातु निर्देशे सो टिप इज नॉट यूज हियर सो आई विल जस्ट स्किप टू इक सो इक एंड स्टिप आर यूज फॉर एज धातु निर्देश टू पॉइंट आउट द धातु बिकॉज धातु के नॉट बी यूज विदाउट डिक्लाइनिंग एंड यू के नॉट डिक्लाइन अ धातु एज अ सुबंत सो फॉर दैट स्टिप प्रत्यय और इक प्रत्यय इक इज एडेड हियर टू गेट नश नश प्लस इक विल गिव यू नशी सो नशी इज बेसिकली अ प्रातिपदिका विच कैन डिक्लाइन विच इज इन द मीनिंग ऑफ धातु सो नशी मीन्स ओनली नश धातु लाइक भवती भवती विल मीन द भू धातु नॉट भवती थिंग अंत बट भवती विच हैज टेकन तिप प्रत्यय स्टिप प्रत्यय इक स्टिपौ सॉरी सो आई जस्ट वॉज राइटिंग समथिंग पकार सो इक स्टिपौ धातु इन दिस सो हियर स्टिप हैज नॉट बीन यूज इक हैज बीन यूज द शकार हियर इज टू मेक इट शित एंड देयर बाय सारो धातु का सो सारो धातु का विल गिव एवरीथिंग दैट यू गेट इन तिंगंत डिक्लेनेशन सो शप विल कम इन एटसेट्रा फॉर भू शप विल कम इन विल सी द डिक्लेनेशन इन एनी वे तिंगंत विल फॉलो सून होपफुली सो देर विल सी द डिक्लेनेशन सो शप कम्स इन एंड देन भू बिकम्स भो एंड देन एच ओ आई विल गिव यू भव भू प्लस अ शप कंटेंट इज अ एंड देन ती सो यू विल गेट भवती सिमिलरली दिस दैट इज अ तिंगंत भवती मीनिंग ही शी इट एग्जिस्ट बट हियर If you add to bhudhatu, you add stip, you will get the same karya as in tinganta, but bhavati will be a similar form, but it is a subanta, which means only the dhatu. It has no meaning of he, she, it goes, it exists. It has only bhu, satta, dhatu meaning. So you can say bhavate he adesha. So it will mean this is adesha for bhudhatu. Similarly, nasherva, nashi, with ik, it will become a dhatu, nash will become nashi. And it is a dhatu. Which dhatu? It is a pada, it is a pratipadika which talks about the dhatu nash. So nasher va kuhu. So ku adesha ka varga. Adesha is there for nash. Va optionally. Optionally padasyante. When it is at the end of the pada. So as we saw, this kvibanta dhatu kvibanta dhatuttvam na jahati. So the dhatu sanya at the of that which is at the end of this. क्विबंत पद और प्रातिपदिका दे विल रिटेन दी धातु संज्ञा ऑल्सो सो नश धातु इज सीन इन दी नश प्रातिपदिका ऑल्सो एंड एट दी पद ऑल्सो एट दी एंड ऑफ दी पद नश विल ऑल्सो हैव अ धातु एट नश सो इट इज अ नश एंडिंग धातु नश धातु एंडिंग प्रातिपदिका ऑल्सो एंड नश धातु एंडिंग पद ऑल्सो देर बाय व्हाट विल हैपन व्हेन यू आर डिक्लाइनिंग लघुकार सेज नशे कवर्गा अंतादेश वा पदांते एट दी एंड ऑफ दी पद The anta adesha will be ka varga adesha for nash dhatu. So you can see what will happen nash plus su. Halnyabhyo hal, su and hal. So halnya dirga sutisya prutam hal lopa lupyate. Su will go away. So you have nash. Nash is suptingantam padam now. And now vrashcha vrashcha srujamuja yaja. Sorry. Vrashcha vrashcha srujamuja yaja raja bhraja chashamsha. So shakara ending will get murdanya shakara adesha. षण्मुख शकार आदेश फॉर शंकर शकार एंडिंग झली पदस्य अंते सो एट द एंड ऑफ द पद शकार विल बिकम शकार सो नश देन झलाम जशोंते वी हैव सीन इट विल बिकम डकार जस्तम देन नशेर वा कु पदस्य अंते इफ इट इफ यू यूज दिस नशेर वा कु देन यू विल गेट नग बिकॉज ट वर्ग ट ठ ढ वर्ग तृतीया विल बिकम क वर्ग वर्ग तृतीया क ख ग दिस इज ऑप्शनल सो इट इज ऑप्शनल Once you take this, what will happen? Nag, va avasani, you will get nak. So this is, nag is, this is one form. You can keep it here, one form. Second form is nak. Why? Char to va avasani char. So with char, the form, with ka varga, first, nag. Then char to is also optional, va avasani, therefore nak. Now, what happens is that, here this is nasherva, so okay, we'll go back. Then pakshe, what have pakshe? Pakshe means if you do not take these two, nasherva if you don't take, then this will also not apply. If nasherva you don't take, then vavasani will not apply with gakara. Then what will it apply with? Vavasani will apply, but you have not taken the nasherva ku option. So then what happens? Nad will remain nad. So it will not, dakara will not become gakara. So this is the third form, nad. Then fourth form is vavasani. Dakara can become varga prathama of the same varga. So ta, tha, da. So it can go back to varga prathama char, which is nut. So this is the fourth form. So you will get nad, nut, nag or nak. These are the four forms as Lagukara mentioned. Nak, nag, nut or nad. So this is with, these two forms are with what? With kutvam. With ku, which is optional. Nasherva, ku. And these are without ku. Without ku. And in that also, this is a jash form. This is a char form. Jash form. And this is a char form. Similarly here, char form, nak, and nag is what? Is jash form. So you got four forms. So you'll have what? Nak, nag, nut, nad. What does it mean? One who destructs, or that which destructs or perishes, ceases to be, in that meaning, unmanifest. Then varna melana, all that is same as earlier. Nasho, nashaha, nasham. The only difference is that with pada, you will get kutva optionally. Therefore, if you get kutva, you use nasherva, then you will get nagbhyam. If you do not use kutvam, then nadbhyam. So, non-ku form is nadbhyam. With ku, you will get nagbhyam. There is no chartam at all because it is not followed by khar and there is no avasana. Similarly, nagbhi, nadbhi, nagbhya, nadbhya. And in the last form, nakshu. This is with nakshu. Natsu, natsu. So these two forms here are with what? Non-ku, non-kutvam. With kutvam you will get this form, only one form. Why only one form with kutvam? Because kakara will be preceding with kutvam. You will get gakara, first you will get gakara, nad will become nag. But it is followed by sakara, therefore chartvam. Chartvam is mandatory, kharicha. So here by kharicha chartvam. So chartvam is mandatory, there is no optionality there, therefore will be only one form, nakshu. Here there are two forms because natsu, here also chartvam will give only one form, but this is with dhud. So this is with dhudagama. With dhudagama you will get additional form, natsu. So those are the four forms there, nasho, nashaha, ityadi, nagbhyam, nadbhyam. So he gives two forms here. So nagbhyam, nadbhyam, or further nagbhi, nadbhi, or nagbhyaha, nadbhyaha. The next form considered for declension is ghrutasprush. Ghrutasprush. So ghrutasprush, ghruta is ghee. One who touches ghee will be called as ghrutasprush. So there is a particular sutra, vidhi sutra. So this is an upapada tatpurusha. स्पृशो अनुदके क्विन सुपी. सो सुपी सप्तमी एक वचन. स्पृशो अनुदके क्विन. क्विन इज ऑर्डेन आफ्टर स्पृश धातु. सो पंचमी एक वचन, सॉरी, आफ्टर स्पृश धातु क्विन इज ऑर्डेन सुपी. एंड हियर ऑल्सो अनुदके वेन नॉट इन दी. सो दिस इज विषय सप्तमी. वेन इट इज नॉट इन द मीनिंग ऑफ उदक, सॉरी नॉट विषय सप्तमी, उपपद तत्पुरुषा, आई एम सॉरी, उपपद सप्तमी. सो दिस उपपद सप्तमी मीनिंग व्हेन दी उपपद इज नॉट उदक, द शब्द इज नॉट उदक. व्हेन उदक मीन्स वॉटर बट नॉट दी मीनिंग हियर. शब्द यू हैव टू टेक इन व्याकरण, यू हैव टू टेक दी शब्द रूप. सो अनुदके, अनुदके मीन्स, सो हियर वन थिंग यू हैव टू नो, इन व्याकरण सूत्र द मीनिंग शुड नॉट बी टेकन अनलेस स्पेसिफिकली मेन्शन outside the vyakarana. For example, let's say in non vyakarana, in the loka, when you say let's say here udaka itself, let's say ramah udakam उदकम पिबति. सो लेट्स से पिबति ड्रिंक्स, रामा ड्रिंक्स वाटर. सो हियर द मीनिंग ऑफ वाटर हैज टू बी टेकन. और लेट्स से रामः, व्हेन यू वांट टू से उदकम, ही सेज उदकम. सो उदकम वदति विल नॉट मेक सेंस. सो देयरफॉर व्हाट इज डन, उदकम इति वदति. व्हेन ही सेज समथिंग, ही सेज वाटर. व्हाट डिड यू ड्रिंक, यू आस्क रामा, ही सेज उदकम इति वदति. सो देयर इति इज एडेड टू शो दैट उदकम इज नॉट वाटर इन नॉट द इट डज नॉट द इन उदकम इन द सेंटेंस डज नॉट मीन वॉटर बट इट मीन्स द शब्द उदकम. सो ही सेज उदकम इति. वॉट डिड यू ड्रिंक, उदकम इति. इफ ही सेज उदकम आई ड्रैंक उदकम, देर इट विल बी डिफरेंट. बट उदकम इति वेन यू एड देन इट मीन्स शब्द रूप. उदकम इति वदति, ही सेज उदकम इति, ही जस्ट सेज द वर्ड उदकम. सो सिमिलरली हियर इन आई थिंक इन अष्टाध्याय इटसेल्फ देर इज अग्नेर ढक प्रत्यय. आई थिंक अग्नेर, लेट मी जस्ट क्रॉस चेक. एज एन एग्जाम्पल, अग्नि एग्जाम्पल इज गिवन देयर टू एक्सप्लेन दैट अग्नेर, अग्नेर ढक. सो देर इज अ सूत्र अग्नेर ढक इन तद्धिताधिकार, अग्नेर ढक. सो वेन अग्नेर ढक इज मेन्शन, अग्नेर ढक, अग्नेर ढक, दिस इज अ सूत्र. सो आफ्टर द अग्नि देर इज ढक. सो हियर अग्नि इज मेन्शन विदाउट एन इति इन द लोक, दिस इज हाउ द प्रयोग इज. बट इन व्याकरण सूत्रास व्हाट इज द प्रयोग हियर इन द सूत्र, सूत्र प्रयोग इज दिस सूत्रम, देर यू डोंट यूज इति. सो वेन इति इज नॉट यूज अग्नेर ढक देन इट मीन्स अग्नि इज अ शब्द रूप. हियर इट इज अर्थ विथ इति इट इज वॉट, इट इज शब्द. बट इन व्याकरण शास्त्र वेन इति इज नॉट मेन्शन देन इट मीन्स वॉट, अग्नि मीन्स अग्नि शब्द. बट वेन इति इज मेन्शन, वेन इति इज मेन्शन देन इट विल मीन वॉट, दे विथ इति समथिंग प्लस इति दिस समथिंग विल बी अर्थ मीनिंग. सो दिस इज अ एग्जैक्ट अपोजिट फ्रॉम द लोक. सो हियर इफ यू से स्पृश अनुदके क्विन सुपी, देन अनुदके मीन्स अनुदक, नॉन उदक मीन्स डज नॉट मीन मीनिंग वेन जला वर्ड इज नॉट देर. बट हियर इट मीन्स दैट वेन यू आर द उदक शब्द इज नॉट अदर देन उदक शब्द. सो हियर अदर देन उदक शब्द इज घृत. सो वन हू टच इज घृत देर यू विल सी एज टू वॉट. हियर देर इज अ सेम इश्यू एज अर्लियर. सी यू कैन क्रॉस चेक विथ अदर्स बट आई हैव मेन्शन दिस न्यस. एवरी टाइम शी यूज न्यस हियर इन उपपद तत्पुरुष इट शुड बी अम. दिस इज माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग बट शी इज गिवन ए पर्टिकुलर नोट. दिस इज चिंतनीयम. ओके, नोट दैट घृत टेक्स कर्मणी षष्ठी बाय कर्तृकर्मणो कृति बिकॉज प्रश इज कृदंत. बिकॉज प्रश इज कृदंत शी सेज दैट हियर न्यस प्रत्यय शुड बी एडेड नॉट अम. नाउ दिस इज समथिंग दैट आई हैव नॉट कम अक्रॉस नॉर हैव आई नॉर डू आई थिंक इट इज राइट बट शी हैज मेंशन्ड दिस स्पेसिफिकली. देर आई डोंट नो विच इज अ प्रमाण फॉर दिस. कर्तृकर्मणो कृति इज नॉट अ प्रमाण टू मी. दिस इज एप्लीकेबल ओनली वेन यू आर नॉट मेकिंग एन उपपद समास इन माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग बिकॉज यू कैनॉट हैव सी घृतम. देर हैज टू बी एन इंडिपेंडेंट स्पृश शब्द. इफ एन इंडिपेंडेंट स्पृश शब्द इज देर विच इज अ कृदंता देन आई एग्री विथ वॉट शी हैज सेड. बट इन माई अंडरस्टैंडिंग वेन देर इज अ स्पृशो अनुदके क्वीन काइंड ऑफ अ सूत्र विच गिवज यू एन विच ऑर्डेंस एन उपपद तत्पुरुष दैट टाइम दिस स्पृश धातु कैनॉट टेक क्वीन एंड बिकम ए स्पृश इट सेल्फ अनलेस देर इज एन उपपद. विदाउट द उपपद इट कैनॉट टेक. सो देर कैनॉट बी एन इंडिपेंडेंट स्पृश शब्द एट ऑल. वेन यू हैव एन इंडिपेंडेंट स्पृश शब्द देन यू विल हैव षष्टी कर्मणी षष्टी बाय कर्तृकर्मणो कृति. फॉर एग्जाम्पल, आई मीन एन एग्जाम्पल इज गिवन एज टू लेट से घटकृत, वन हु मेक्स द घट. सो कृ प्रत्यय विल टेक क्विप बाय विच सूत्र क्विप च इत्यादि एंड मेक अ कर्ता. सो वन हु मेक्स द घट there ghata is upapada, karmani upapade. So it will take karmani upapade in second case. Ghata plus am, ghatam karoti iti ghatakrut. So my vritti will be ghatam karoti, not ghatasya karoti. I cannot have ghatasya karoti. There is no such prayoga at all. Shashti should not be used. Only karmani dvitiya is used. Therefore, I'll say ghatam karoti iti ghatakrut. So my vritti is very clear. Vigrahavakya for upapada tatpurusha is ghatam karoti iti ghatakrut. Therefore, krut will can be this kru dhatu can take quip and will become kru and it will bring in tugagama, so it will become krut. So pugantasya puganta dhatu not sorry sorry hraswasya pitikriti tuk. So hraswasya pitikriti tuk will bring a tugagama and it will become ghatakrut. So here the meaning is ghatakarta. Although the meaning is ghatakarta, karta shabda can decline on its own by taking kru plus truch. So kru plus truch is independent of the upapada. I don't need an upapada. There it will become what? Ghatasya karta shashti tat purusha. Ghatasya karta. Because karta is an independent shabda. But krut is not an independent shabda. Krut will become krut only with some upapada. Ghata, pata, patakrut, ghatakrut, ityadi. Therefore, krut not being independent, you cannot say ghatasya krut. You have to say ghatam karoti. So karoti has become krut here. So similarly, I don't think sprush can take quin pratyaya or any pratyaya, so to say, for that matter, without the upapada. So personally, I would question this. It has been mentioned, so since I have been marking it as all the gnas as she has particularly mentioned this, so I'll question this. I don't know that this is a pramana. I have not seen it. I may be wrong. So this you can take with a pinch of salt. I have been marking all six cases as second case singular because my I don't know the ghatasya spruk unless ghrutasya spruk. So ghrutaspruk, whether it is ghrutasya spruk. If it is ghrutasya spruk, then I am wrong. But I don't think it is ghrutasya spruk. Then it will be Shashti Tat Purusha. It will not be Upapada. And if it is Shashti Tat Purusha, I don't think it will be in this Dhatu Adhikara at all. So Upapada Tat Purusha are all like this. Ghruta Sprush. So this is my, let me just cross check since, see Ghrutam Sprushati. Vachaspatyam is very clear. So I have put it here question mark. I would say it is wrong. Okay, because Vachaspatya also says Ghrutam Sprushati iti Ghruta Sprush. There is absolutely no way you will get Shashti. There is absolutely no, because Ghrutam Sprushati means where will you get Shashti from? Ghruta plus Am is there. Ghruta plus Am in your Vigraha Vakya. You cannot have Vigraha Vakya different and Pratyaya different. In the Vigraha Vakya itself, you will have to. This is a Laukika Vigraha Vakya. Alaukika Vigraha Vakya will be replacing the Shabda in the Laukika Vigraha with the Pratyaya. Therefore, I cannot have here, see, anudake supi upapade sprushehe quin. Only with the upapada will you get it. So upapada, in which case should it go? So here karmani upapade will work. You cannot have shashti at all. Therefore, you will say ghrutam sprushati iti. Sprushati, one who touches ghruta is ghruta sprush. So this ghruta, ghrutam, now this is laukika vigravakya. Alaukika will be ghruta plus because it is in second case. There is no ghrutasya sprushati. There is ghrutam sprushati. And then you will have sprushati. Sprushdhatu. And sprushdhatu, sprushati. The sprushdhatu will take quin pratyaya. This is how the formation is. You cannot have suddenly, randomly, you cannot use, kartu karmano kruti, therefore you bring in shashti. You cannot do that. It is not kridanta at all. It is in prakriya avastha. Mind you, if you go through this Karmani Shashti Kruti, Sprusha is Krudanta. Sprusha is not Krudanta at all. It is not Krudanta. Sprusha is not Krudanta. Sprusha is actually what? The if you look at it in the Adhikara, I'll just show you the Adhikara, how you have to be careful. 3 to 58. If you go to 3 to 58, I mean, this is what I have learned. If there are some other rules, I do not know, but the Tika. So if you look at 3 to, is it 3 to what? 3 to 58. Look at 3 to 58 here. See, Sprusho Anudake Queen. Right? This is the. But if you look at it, Papada. All this is in Karmani and Nityadi. So 3191 the Adhikara starts. This is Dhatu Adhikara. Tatra Upapadam Saptamistam. Then Krita thing. Krita is that which is non thing. And if you look at it, Upapada Tatpurusha. Not here, I think. Dukshehe. I was looking for something particularly. I'm unable to recollect that. But what I wanted to say is that, see, this is all in the Dhatu Adhikara Pratyah Parashya. So Pratyah is added. And you will get a Krudanta only when you have declined it. In the Prakriya Avastha itself, it will take an Upapada. So Upapada Tatpurusha is in this manner. When we look at Samasas, maybe we will revisit. So I'm unable to get to the Sutra proper. I just wanted to show you the Adhikara, this entire Adhikara from 3191. From 3191 till 3476 is Krut. So it is right that it will become a Krudanta, but it is not a Krudanta yet. The difference between, see, non thing is all Krut Pratyaya. Just because it is taking a Krut Pratyaya, Sprush will not become Krudanta. Sprush is still a Dhatu. So therefore, I was just trying to, just give me one moment. Adhatoho. I think Adhatoho. Let me look up, I'll come back. For Upapada Tatpurusha, there is a word which is Adhato. When to non Dhatu, it is added. So it is, it is just before it becomes a Pada, it has to become a Krut Taddit or Samasa. And although it is taking a Krut Pratyaya and it will become Krudanta only after it has taken an Upapada. Because the particular, even Laghuvritti also, Anudake Supi Upapade. Only when there is Upapada which is not Udaka, along with that Sprusheyakvin. You cannot just say Sprusheyakvin. Had it been Sprusheyakvin, then you can say Sprush is Krudanta. Sprush is not Krudanta. What is Krudanta? It only Ghruta plus plus Sprush plus Quin is Krudanta. Meaning Ghruta plus Sprug, this is Krudanta. This entire Shabda is Krudanta. You can say Upapada Samasa, it's a Krudanta Shabda, but it is not. Only Sprush. Sprush is a Dhatu, it is not taking Quin independently. That is the idea. You have to read an Upapada along with it and then only it will work. We'll see more in the how to differentiate this. This is a little tricky, you know. Upapada Tatpurusha is, you know, it is a Samasa, all right, but it is in the Krit section, it is not in the Samasa section. So there is some difficulty. To understand the vritti also for Upapada Tatpurusha is a little tricky, because it is in the Prakriya Avastha that the Pratyaya is added. Because Dhatu takes Pratyaya. Krut Pratyaya is taken by Dhatu. And when it takes Krut, you should get a Krudanta. You end up getting an Upapada Tatpurusha Samasa. So how does it work? So it is neither a Dhatu, nor a Pada, nor a Pratipadika. I mean, it is really very difficult to point out what it is. So it is like, you know, in Vedanta, Advaita Vedantis have this Mithya. Mithya definition is very difficult to understand. It cannot be said Idamittham. It is not Sat. It is not Asat. So it is to differentiate from something else. So it is said that a non-dhatu, it is in the Prakriya Avastha, you cannot call it as a Dhatu. You cannot call it as a Krudanta Shabda. So Samasa, so generally Samasa is Supasa. So it is not with Subanta. Subanta with Subanta will give you a Samasa. But here it is not so. Therefore, it is non-Subanta with which there is a Samasa. Dhatu is having Samasa. So how can you have Dhatu have Samasa with the Upapada which is a Subanta? So it's very tricky area. You know, it is like another tricky area is Taddita. Entire thing is a tricky area. But in Taddita, if you have heard Chvi Pratyanta, for example, Shukli Karoti. So what is Shukli Krutam, Shukli Krutya, Shukli Karoti? All these are considered a Samasa. There can be a Tinganta Pada in the Samasa. There can be a Krudanta in the Samasa. and there is a taddhita word. So shukli krutya, this is also samasa. How it becomes a samasa with a tinganta or a, with a krutya, all these are very difficult areas. Unless we go to tika level or mahabhashya level, we don't get everything. So this laghu is really laghu. So these are all questionable areas where we have to spend a lot of time to understand if we have you know, such interest in the details. But otherwise, I would say that Ghruta plus Sprusha plus Queen, because on the face of it, there is absolutely no way that you will get Nyas here. There is no Kartru Karmano Kruti hi Pravrutti at all there. This is my understanding. Because Sprusha is Krutanta, first this has to be, because Hetu has to be established in Tarka. So you say, you know, Parvato Vanniman Dhumat. I agree that Dhuma has been established as Hetu. As what? Hetu to establish Jnana of the Vanni. Dhuma is not Hetu for Vanni. For Agni, Hetu is not Dhuma. In fact, for Dhuma, Hetu is Agni. So in the Vishaya, in the Vastu, fire is the cause of smoke. But smoke is the cause for what? Smoke is the cause for the Jnana of the smoke is the cause for Jnana of Agni. So it is reverse. Fire is the cause for smoke. Therefore, if you see smoke, then knowledge of smoke is the cause to give rise to the knowledge of Anumana for the knowledge of fire. This is how Tarka works. Now, because Prush is Kridanta, Kartra Karmano Kruti should be applied, and this Ghrita should go in Shashti. Karmani Shashti, Karma goes in sixth case for Kridanta, Karta as well as Karma will go in sixth case for Kridanta. But Kridanta Sprush is not established as Kridanta. How will you establish Sprush as Kridanta at all? If that is the case, then Sprush should be derived separately, and then you can take Ghrita, and then you can say Ghritasya Sprush. Won't work, because Sprush cannot be derived separately. Unless it takes a quip pratyaya. If it takes a quip pratyaya, then sprush can become a karta. But here you are giving quin pratyaya. If you are saying sprush plus quip is equal to sprush, meaning a person who touches, that's all. Touches what? Then you will say, okay, touches ghee, then you will say ghritasya sprush. It may work there. That is a shashti tatpurusha. Here you are deriving upabada tatpurusha. Here there is a quin pratyaya ordained, not quip pratyaya. Therefore, it won't work. All this complexity, because I have said many times in the earlier many a patha that there is no shashti, there is to clarify my perspective I am saying, and now it is clear as to why she has used shashti. Doesn't look like a typo, that seems to be thinking. So Medhaji seems to think so, or it is a typo, I do not know. Here we have seen this note, I may have missed it earlier. If you come across this note earlier also, please understand with this background. I don't know whether it helps, but this has to be mentioned. So what happens is that this will be replaced by, will go away by, because it is a samasa, krutyat samasa ascha. I would consider it as a samasa, but then for that we need more sutra study. So currently, krut or samasa, one of these two reasons because of which it will become pratipadika. Then you will have ghrita plus rush, ghrita sprush. This is a pratipadika. How does it decline? Same sutras will apply which we have seen. So soon will go away by halniyabhyav dirgat sutisya pruktam hallopaha. Ghritasprush is a pada now, suptingandam padam. Ghritasprush by vrashcha vrashja nimitta is shankar shakara ending dhatu will take murdhanya adesha at padanta. Padasya anta is the nimitta here, not jhal, jali. Then jastam will give you ghritasprud. Then quin pratyasya ku will give you kutvam. Vargatritiya will give you tathada will become kakhaga. This is the first form, Ghritasprug. The second form is Vavasani Char, Gakara will become Kakara, Ghritasprug. Then Varnamila Ghritasprushav, Ghritasprusha Rutta Visarga. So all that is same, what we have seen earlier. The difference is, there is no difference, what we have seen. Same here, this Padasthana you will get Gakara, all these sthanas. Here you will get with Kharicha, because Sakara following is a Khar letter, and Inkoho will give you Murdhanya also, you will get Ghritas Prakshu. So entire declension is like Tadrush, similar to that. We look at Dadrush in the next patha. So all these will have similar declension. There is a certain difference which we will see as to at some places there is Asiddhatvam. what goes by in Tripadi, those sutras cannot see the karya of the latter. So in the derivation, if you have already used the latter sutra, when you go further with different pratyas, you revisit, there is it cannot see the earlier set of sutras that you have used. And if it is a latter sutra in the Tripadi, there is asiddhatvam. So we'll see something like that further. I don't know whether it has gone by. Rutva we had not seen, so we'll see when we hit that sutra. नृतावसाने नटराजराजो ननाधडक्कान्नवपञ्चवारम् उद्धरतु कामः सनकादिसिद्धान् एतद्विमर्शे शिवसूत्रजालम्. सो ऐ थिङ्क्